Matthew chapter 5, verse 43 to 46, then 48.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 43.
You have heard that it was said.
Unasikia kama imeandikwa, imesemwa.
Tafadhali mtusaidie watoto, tafadhali, tendelea pale. Thank you. You have heard that it was said.
Unasikia kama imesemwa.
Love your neighbor and hate your enemy.
Mpende jirani yako, mchukie adui yako.
But I tell you, love your enemy and pray for those who persecute you.
Lakini nakwambia mpende adui yako na wale ambao hawakupendi.
Waombee wale.
Naombea wale ambao hawakupendi.
But I tell you, love your enemy.
Lakini nakwambia upende adui zako.
And pray for those who persecute you.
Na uombee wale ambao wanakutesa.
That you may be children of your Father who is in heaven.
Pale ndio utakuwa mtoto wa babako mwenye uko mbinguni.
For he makes his son to rise on the evil and the good.
Ambaye aliweka jua kwa waovu na watenda mema.
Yes. And send rain on the just and unjust.
Na hali nyeshesha kwa wema na wasio wema.
If you love those who love you, what reward will you get?
Kama unapenda wale, kama unapenda wale ambao wanakupenda, ni taji gani utapata?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay, let me start by there. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Baba, ni katika jina la Yesu.
I humble myself before the throne of grace.
Ninajisalimisha mbele zako.
I want your grace to be upon us this evening.
Tunaomba neema yako iwe pamoja nasi jioni.
I want the Holy Spirit to be among us and to reign.
Tunaomba Roho wako Mtakatifu akuwe kati yetu.
Manifest yourself, Lord. We are in your presence.
Baba, jitukuze, tuko katika uwepo wako.
In your presence there is glory.
Uwepo wako Baba kuna utukufu.
In your presence there is power.
Uwepo wako mna uwezo.
In your presence there is life.
Uwepo wako mna.
In your presence there is hope.
Uwepo wako mko tumaini.
We want you, Lord, to be manifested.
Baba, tunaomba ujitukuze.
Come among us.
Njoo kati yetu.
Come among us, Lord.
Njoo kati yetu.
Thank you for your will be done in this place.
Tunasema asante na wacha
mapenzi yako. And I want you, Lord, through this word to touch everyone who can hear my voice. Lord, I want you to transform everyone through this word. Because of the word, everything was made. Everything was made, was created through the word. I want you to create hope this evening. I want you to create life through this evening. I want you to create love today. I want you to create peace. Father, nothing is impossible. You can do everything. Today. 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 I want you to transform life. Bless this word. Bless this word. Bless this time. Bless everyone who can hear. Bless every heart. Bless every soul. In the mighty name of Jesus. And I rebuke every spirit of distraction. In Jesus Christ's name. Amen, amen, amen. Let us take our seats. Again, as I used to say all the time, the word of God does not come by mistakes. There is always a reason why the word of God came among us. That's why you are called to hear, to open your ear, to understand the mind of God today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If we are together, can you clap your hand for the glory of Jesus Christ? Jesus is speaking to us this evening.
Yes, you can again see a journey.
Again, he's speaking to you this
this evening. On this moment, Jesus Christ is talking to you. Today, he is here and talking to you. But Jesus said, you have heard. It said, love your neighbor and hate your enemies. Yes, that some people are living like that. Yeah, there's people who hate their enemy. My brother and my sister. That is a kind of the vengeance. Vengeance is not good to any believer. But I want to tell you who is an enemy. The enemy is the person who is actively opposed.
He
is your adversary. Yeah, he's against you, against your peace, against your Lord, against your love. He's against your life, against your joy. He
do
not want you to succeed. The enemy is always there, just he wants you to die. So whenever you succeed, you will not be happy. So but why we do have enemies? Why we do have enemies? Sometimes we are making ourselves enemies because of what someone did against us. Because someone did something against me means he become my enemy. Who is my enemy? My brother and my sister. Before I continue, I want to tell you, our first enemy is Satan, the devil. He is the master of every failure, every problem. But he is using other people to attack us. He used people to destroy our life. He used people to steal our peace. The devil used people to kill our joy. But our neighbor are not enemies. My brother is not my enemy. My friend is not my enemy. The one who was created by the image and likeness of God is not my enemy. But my enemy is Satan the devil. He is behind any problem. I remember the day when Jesus was talking about, when he was talking, I want to go to the cross. And Peter stood up and said, you cannot go to the cross. And Jesus rebuked Satan. He didn't rebuke Peter. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So whenever you see your friend doing something against you, just you must know one thing. It's Satan who is behind your friend. Do not rebuke your friends. Do not rebuke your neighbor. Do not hate your friend. But rebuke Satan who is behind your friend. If you have a spiritual eyes, you will see Satan behind your friend. If you are walking on the side, you will not have enemies in this life. So we have today people become enemies. Enemies are everywhere. Because we have a different church, you become my enemy. Because you have a different faith, you are my enemy. We cannot work together. We cannot pray together. We cannot eat together. We cannot sit together. Because you have a different church and I have a different church. Because you have a different faith and I have a different faith. People become enemies because of age. People become enemies because of race, skin. People become enemies because of tribe. People become enemies because of nationality. My brother and my sister. But today, the Lord wants to open our eyes. You can see even today. People used to work together, but today it may be your enemy and you do not know. People you used to eat together, but today they become your enemy. Even people you help, today they become your enemy. But you do not understand why that. You think he is your enemy. But the first day, I want to give you an example. He used to be the great enemy, the great friend. And you used to preach with him 3 times a day. When he starts to go back, he's starting to change the name, to become enemy, he will greet you 2 times a day. Again, if he continue, he will greet you 1 time a day. And if he continue, he will stop to greet you. And he will run away from you. He will run away from you. Today, people become enemies. Do you have any enemy in your life? Do you have any enemy in your life? But Jesus says, if you love those who love you, what reward will you get? If you love only people who love you, my friend and my sister, people today, they love those who love and people who love them. Maybe you are among us. You have some people, they have already, they become your enemy. You used to preach that you need to work with them. And you do not love them anymore because they did something wrong. Maybe they insulted you last time. Maybe they did something that did not please you. So when you see them, you become angry. When you see them, you run from the place where you are. You know, if you are in that stage, means you do not have a peace in you. My brother and my sister, even pagan, people who do not believe in God, people who do not go to church, they love people who love them. They help people who help them. But according to this passage today, I understand something very important. God wants you and me to go beyond the natural. God wants me and you to go beyond the wall, to cross the wall.
Mungu anapenda mimi na wewe tuende tutambuke hiyo
mpaka. Yes, hallelujah. Thank you. God bless you, Florence. We miss you for a long time, Florence. We miss you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you in the church today, isn't it? You come to hear the word of God. But according to our topic today, you to cross the river.
Mungu anapenda utambuke, utambuke.
Maybe there is a river of enemies in front of you.
Labda kuko kisima kya maadui mbele.
There is a barrier in front of you.
Labda kuko eko barrier.
That barrier is telling you, do not greet that man.
Na hile iko na kuambia usimsalimie.
According to what Jesus says.
Na kutokana na kisi Yesu anasema.
The world says.
Neno nasema. Dunia nasema.
Yes. The world says.
Dunia nasema.
Love your neighbor.
Penda
jirani. Love your friends. Hate your enemies. But God is calling you and me to love our enemies. To love our enemies. So my brother and my sister, today, through these words, I pray God to give us the power to understand what is the will of God. To understand the will of God. Because enemies are everywhere. And many of people become enemies and you do not know they are hypocrites. They may come in front of you in life, but he is your enemy and you do not know. The same way Judah was among the disciples of Jesus. He walked together with them. And when people saw Judah among them, they said, this is the disciple of Jesus Christ. The appearance doesn't mean anything. The problem is the interior. What is inside of that person called
Judah?
When you see Judah, he went in the presence of Jesus. And Judah kissed Jesus. Judah kissed Jesus. I want you to understand. Hallelujah. I want you to understand something. When you see someone kiss another person, you will say those people, they are in love.
Wow.
I want to repeat again. When you see someone kiss another person, you will say they are in love. I want to tell you, brothers and sisters, Judah was a killer. Judah was a hypocrite. Brothers and sisters, many people today become like Judah. Many people become like Judah. They are among you, but they are your enemies. They are in the churches, but they are enemies. They are in a long friend, but they are enemies. My brother and my sister, but God wants to help us today to understand. And he wants us to go over. According to our message today, God is telling you and me, do not care about what people are doing against you. Do not care about your friends are doing against you. Do not care about what they say. It doesn't matter if they kill your friends. It doesn't matter if they destroy your life. It doesn't matter if they did anything great that you can't think in your mind. But the Lord God is calling me and you to love your neighbor and to love your enemy. To love your neighbor and to love your enemy. Let me tell you something very important. Why people have many enemies? Because we do not have the spirit of forgiveness. Where there is no forgiveness, there is no peace. Where there is no forgiveness, there is no unity. Where there is no forgiveness, there is no love. Where there is no forgiveness, there is no life of God. My brother and my sister, God is calling you and he wants you to have the fruit of forgiveness. Forgiveness is life. Forgiveness is the power of God. Listen, to hate it very easy. To hate someone, it's very easy. But to love, you need to follow the requirement of God. Because of that, people will become the enemies. They don't want to follow the rules, the way of God. Why we do not forgive? We are comparing ourselves to other people. Why he did this against me? Who he think he is? He think he is strong than me? For you to forgive, you need to forget your title. You need to forget your name. You need to forget your title, your degrees. You need to forget your education. You need to forget the name of your family. Maybe if you are a president family, you need to forget it. My brother and sister, forgiveness needs people who are humble. If you forgive, you have the humbleness, you will be able to love your neighbor. Hallelujah. Can we clap our hands for the glory of Jesus? Listen. Wow. Brother and sister, we need to be careful the way we are living. We need to be careful the way we are living. Jesus Christ is about to come. Jesus is about to come. If you are not able to forgive your friend or your neighbor, Jesus will not come for you. Again, if you are not able to forgive your neighbor or your friend, the Lord Jesus will not come for you. You will come for those who are ready to inherit the kingdom of heaven. It is time to forgive. The Bible says, God says in Luke chapter 11, verse 4, and forgive us our sin as we forgive those who sin against us.
Whoa.
If you do not forgive, God will never forgive you. Again, if you do not forgive, God will never forgive you. Again, if you do not forgive, God will never forgive you. Heart, there is people you never forget. Remember, the same sin you did before remains in your head. It is time to forgive. For the Lord Jesus Christ is about to return back. Forgiveness. 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 It's time to forgive. And God knows you can forgive. You can forgive. Again, you can forgive. Do not say I can't. Do not say I still have a pain. I remember what you did. One thing I know, according to the Bible, you can forgive. Forgiveness is possible. Forgiveness is possible. And if you do not forgive, you will not see the face of God. If you do not forgive, there is no peace. There will not be the peace of God itself. If you do not be, you forgive, the joy of God will never come to you. But if you take a decision to forgive, the Lord will remember you. If you take a decision to forgive, you will see the love of God upon your life. If you want to forgive, God will be in your side. If you forgive, God will fight. Jesus said,
Yesu anasema,
but I tell you,
lakini ninakwambia,
love your enemy.
Upende adui zako.
People are living now in confusion. Confusion today. Matthew chapter 5, the verse we read today. Jesus said, you have heard that it was said, love your enemy and hate your love your neighbor and hate your enemy. Love your friends, but your enemy hate it. I understand that it's kind of confusion. In the past, they say you must hate your enemy. And when Jesus came, he said, love your enemy. Big confusion among people. Confusion, people, they do not know if they can follow the will of God or the will of people who spoke before. Jesus today said, love your enemy. People are confused. And they do not know which way they can follow. They don't know where there is the truth. They do not know where there is life. My brother and my sister, one thing you must know, Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the life. Jesus says, it says, love your friend and hate your enemy. But me, Jesus, I am telling you today, love your enemy. Love your enemy. Love your enemy. Love your enemy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It is time to love. Joshua chapter 24. Joshua chapter 24 verse 15.
Joshua kitabu chapitre ya
25. The Bible says, but if you refuse to serve the Lord,
lakini kama unakataa kumtumikia Mungu,
then choose today whom you will serve.
Sasa uchague ni nani utakayemtumikia.
And I jump because of time, but as for me and my house will serve the Lord.
Lakini kwa mimi na nyumba yangu tunamtumikia Mungu.
He says, if you refuse to serve or to hear, because you cannot serve God if you do not want to hear him. If you do not serve God, you can choose today who you will serve. Brother and sister, God is calling everyone to please him, not to please yourself, not to please your husband first, not to please your wife first, not to please your parents first, not to please your children first. First, please God. Children can tell you, Father, we do not want you to love our neighbor. My brother and my sister, who are you serving today? Are you doing the will of God or your will? Are you doing what you want or what God wants in your life? Do you know why people fell today? Do you know why people are not getting blessed? You know why people they are not blessed? Because people refuse to follow the way of God. We want to do what we feel we can do. We don't care about God. We don't care about the commandment of God. We don't care about the way of God. But we want to do what we feel we can do. That's why you fail. That's why you fail. Every day whenever I stand up here, Jesus says, without me, you can do nothing. Without me, you can do nothing. Without Jesus, there is no blessings.
Hey!
Hey! Without Jesus, there is no peace and joy. Do you think you will succeed without God? Who taught you that? Who teach you that way? Who told you that you will be blessed without God? Love your enemy. Love everyone in this earth. No one can give him the power to judge or to condemn without reason. There is only one judge. And the day of judgment will come. You want to know. You refuse or not that day will come. And soon and very soon that day will come. If you do not change your life, if you do not love your neighbor, if you do not love your enemy, if you do not love Jesus, that day will catch you one day. The day of judgment. I was afraid one day. I went to see someone, went to the court, and he standing before the judge. When the judge finished to say, and they pop, and they say, this is so, finish.
Na wakati ule jiji alisimama akamaliza sema akapiga kitu akasema unamaliza ongea.
It's over.
Unaisha.
No one continued. No one said please.
Na hakuna mtu alisema tafadhali.
No one said can you give me a minute?
Hakuna mtu alisema simu unaweza nipatia hata minute moja.
Brother and sister.
Ndugu yangu.
Do not waste for your time coming to church and remain the same person years after years, years after years.
Usikuwa unapoteza muda wako kukuya mkanisa kila wakati na unabakia mtu yeye mmoja kila siku.
We have time.
Tuko na muda.
It's now.
Muda ni sasa.
To take a decision.
Ya kukamata tu.
To change.
Ya kubadilika.
To love your neighbor.
Ya kupenda
adui zako. To love your friends.
Ya kupenda
majirani. To walk in the way of God.
Ya kutembea katika njia za Mungu.
I am amazed to see people forget quickly.
Niko na shangaa kuona watu bakiwa wanasahau.
Do you know that death exists?
How do you kama shetani anaiko?
Do you know death exists? Does exist?
Je, unajua kama kifo kinaishi?
Do you forget that?
Je, unajua unasahau?
If you die, you die today.
Je, unajua kama unaweza?
Again, if you die today.
Kama ukikufa leo.
Without being in the good relationship with God. Forget about heaven.
Kama hauna mawasiliano mazuri na Mungu, usahau.
Forget about heaven.
Usahau kuhusu mbinguni.
I don't care what you can think in your head. Forget about heaven.
Sijui ni nini unafikiria lakini nakwambia tu utasahau kuhusu mbinguni.
The word of God will never change because of your behavior.
Neno la Mungu.
The way you are behaving.
Neno la Mungu haliwezi kubadilika kwa ajili ya tabia yako.
God wants you and me to follow his way. That's all. That's all.
Na hiyo tu.
Church.
Kanisa.
Church.
Kanisa.
God love you.
Mungu anakupenda.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is time to do what God wants us to do.
Ni muda wa sisi kufanya ile Mungu anapenda kufanya.
You may say if I follow this way I will suffer a lot and I will die, they will kick me out from my job. Just do it if it is the will of God.
Hausiseme kama nikifanya hivi nitasumbuka sana ama nitahangaika.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But why Jesus is calling the church to love his neighbor, his enemy?
Nijua nini Mungu yuko naita kanisa mpende maadui zenu.
Why Jesus is calling everyone to love his enemy, his friend, his neighbor?
Nijua nini Yesu yuko naita watu wapende majirani zao.
Because hate is not the nature of God.
Kwa sababu chuki hiyo haiko kwa ajili ya Mungu.
It's not in the plan of God to hate. It's not in God.
Hiyo haiko mpango wa Mungu kuchukia.
God is love.
Mungu yeye ni pendo.
The plan of God is love.
Mpango wa Mungu ni
upendo. The word of God is love.
Neno la Mungu ni upendo.
The throne of God is love.
Kiti cha Mungu ni upendo.
The glory of God is love.
Utukufu wa Mungu ni upendo.
Everything about God is love.
Kila kitu kuhusu Mungu ni upendo.
Everything about God is love.
Kila kitu kuhusu Mungu ni upendo.
My brother and my sister. God wants the love inside you overflow.
Mungu anapenda upendo ndani yako ikue zaidi.
Overflow.
Zaidi na ya leo.
When you talk about love,
wakati unaongelea kuhusu upendo,
people don't like it.
Watu hawapendi.
Because people love more money, you know.
Watu kwa sababu watu wanapenda sana pesa.
If I say so it's time to love money, everyone will listen to me and will be happy.
Nikisema kama ni mdogo kupenda pesa kila mtu
atanipenda. And I say if you do this you will get much money, everyone will like it so much.
Nikisema ukifanya hivi utapata pesa mingi kila mtu.
If you do this you will get a house or you will get a nice new car.
Nikukifanya hivi utapata gari ya mzuri ama nyumba
nzuri. Even I stay for 3 hours people will be happy, will not get tired.
Hata nikikala hapa kwa saa 3 watu watashinda choka.
Nothing.
Hakuna kitu.
Nothing.
Hakuna kitu.
Can bless you more than the word of God. Nothing can change your life more than the word of God. Nothing can change your house more than the word of God. Nothing can change your children more than the word of God. You need to know the and sister, how many times they will teach us about the love of God? How many times? If I ask you to love your neighbor, yes, I love them. Okay, amen. You love your enemy? Yes, I love them. Do you really love your enemy? Do you really love people? If you lie to someone, mean there's no love inside of you. When you lie to someone, means there is no love in you. Love is perfect. Love is pure. Love is holy. Love will never pass away. You know what the Bible says? Without love, you are nothing. Without love, you are nothing. Love your enemy. Can you tell your neighbor, love your enemy? That's all. Tell him. Maybe you'll be angry. Just tell him. Just tell him, even if he's angry. Just tell him in love. Love your enemy. It's time. Jesus is about to come. Okay. Let me read something very important. I want to talk again about confusion that people has today. In the book of James, chapter 4, verse 4. The Bible says, you adulterer. Yes. You are adulterers. Oh, this is English, it's not my language. You need to understand that. How do you say? Adulterers. Yeah? Okay, thank you very much. Okay, you adulterers. Don't you realize that friendship with the world makes you enemy of God? Okay. Say it. I say it again.
Okay.
If you want to be a friend of the world, you make yourself an enemy of God. How many people among us are friends of the world? Are you a friend of the world? No. Hakuna mwenye anapenda dunia.
Who is the friend of the world?
Friend of the world. Congratulations. No, I feel pity. Okay, listen. To be a friend of the world means to deny God. To be a friend of the world means to love darkness than light. To be a friend of the world means to be a liar. To be a friend of the world means to be an enemy with your God. To be a friend of the world means to love money more than God. To be an enemy of the world means to refuse the word of God. To be a friend of the world means to refuse prayer. To be a friend of the world means to refuse law. To be a friend of the world means to be a stealer. To be a friend of the world means to refuse the existence of God. To be a friend of the world means you are a friend of are in this world, but you do not belong to this world. You are from heaven. There is someone who created you. God created you. God created you. And he did put his love inside of you. He put his light inside of you. He's calling you today. Stop to love the world. Stop to love the world. Love the Lord your God. Love the Lord of God. God wants you to love him. My brother, do your best in everything to please your God. Your best to please your God in small things or in a big thing. Just be faithful to your God. Be faithful to your God. Be ready to die because of your faithfulness inside of you. Be ready to please your God. Even they say, if you do not lie, we will kill you. Say, kill me, I'm worthy. Kill me, I'm worthy, I will speak the truth. Even they say, if you say the truth, they will kick you out of your apartment. Speak the truth. If you say the truth, they will kick you out from your job. Speak the truth. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the truth. Oh, Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the truth. Yes, Jesus is the truth.
Yes,
I believe Jesus is the truth.
Yes,
we are ready to die for the truth. The truth. The truth. The truth. Hallelujah. I know many people lie so much. So much. So much. You know, to lie is like an identity. It's card. ID card.
Yani kusema uongo inakuwa kama vile nani yako.
Children make their parent to suffer a lot. They lie to their parents without mercy.
Wako watoto wanadanganya wazazi wao bila hata huruma.
Your parents suffer a lot.
Wazazi wako waliteseka sana.
They suffer.
Wako wanateseka sasa.
Reduce a little bit, okay? Speak the truth.
Yani ujiweke ujirudishe kwanza hata kidogo
na ongea kweli. There is women who lie to their husband.
Kuko wanawake wanadanganya sana
kwa mume. They lie without mercy. Oh,
wanadanganya kwa bwana wao bila huruma.
Hey. You know? May the Lord forgive us.
Mungu tu atuhurumie.
Brother and sister.
Ndugu yangu,
if you do not live
kama hauishi
by speaking the truth,
kwa kuongea ukweli,
you are an enemy of Jesus Christ.
Wewe uko adui wa Yesu.
Means you deny Jesus.
Ni kama vile unamkana Yesu.
Jesus is the truth.
Yesu Kristo yeye ni ukweli.
And when you lie means you deny Jesus.
Na wakati unasema uongo unamkataa Yesu.
Brothers and sisters,
ndugu yangu,
believe.
Mkuwe wakati wa
Yesu. Because of the truth.
Yesu halikubali kukufa kwa ajili ya
ukweli. You live in the truth. You are the powerful person in the world.
Kama unaishi katika ukweli wewe ni mtu wa kwanza kwenye uwezo.
Do you know why God does not use many people today?
Unajua nini Mungu hatumikishi watu wengi leo?
Do you know why many people they pray and they don't see the power of the glory of God in their life?
Unajua nini watu wako naomba lakini hawaoni uwezo nguvu za Mungu?
Because they lie a lot.
Kwa sababu tu wanadanganya
wao. And they pray in the church.
Na wanaomba mkanisa.
They lie outside.
Wanadanganya nje.
They come they pray.
Wanakuja wanaomba.
And the God says they lie.
Wanaenda nje wanadanganya.
Control what you speak all the time.
Uko unachunguza wenye uko naongea.
Control your mouth.
Uko unachunguza ulimi wako.
So what do you get?
Sasa ni nini kenye unapata?
There is no blessing but there is curse.
Hakuna iko baraka lakini kuko laana.
Oh God, why you don't answer me?
Nijua nini Mungu haunijibu?
Oh God, I pray. Why only me problems?
Oh Baba, niko naomba, jua nini mimi mashida?
Because you are a liar.
Ni kwa sababu wewe uko muongo.
And Satan the devil is is your father. That is the Bible says. That is the Bible says. That the Bible says. Speak the truth, then God will be your father. Speak the truth, and God will be your father. How come a parent can lie in front of children? In front of children, lie. Someone come to look for the father. And the father said, his daughter, go outside and tell him I am not inside. My brother and my sister, you think you are wise, but you kill your children. You kill your children. You are destroying your family. You are destroying your generation. You are destroying your future. Speak the truth. Speak the truth. Do you want the protection? God to protect you, and there is not the truth inside of you. They call you. Where are you? I am in Alvenon. But you know you are on Speedway. Brothers and sisters, God wants you to love. God wants you to live in love. If you love, you cannot lie on my nature. You cannot lie your supervisor. I am sick. And you are lying. You are not sick,
eh?
You say, I don't want to go to work today. Supervisor, you know, I am sick. Brothers and sisters, please, that makes people to laugh, but be careful that. It's very dangerous. Do you think God is happy on that? God is not happy. God is not happy. God is calling you to make a difference between those who believe in Him and those who do not believe in God.
There
must be a big difference between people who believe in God and those who do not believe in God. The difference is they do not speak the truth. You speak the truth. They lie. You speak the truth. They curse. You bless people. Oh, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to make a big difference.
There
must be a difference. Brothers and sisters, every day you come to church, you speak like people who do not know God. You hate people like the person who does not know God. God wants a difference in your life. God wants a difference in your life. Let people in your apartment know that there is a true Christian in that apartment. Let people see the light of Jesus in your house. It's by speaking the truth. It's by loving your enemy. Ready to die for Jesus. Are you ready to do that? Are you ready to do that? May the Lord help us. But I'm about to finish 2 minutes. Jesus said,
yes,
the same chapter, Matthew chapter 5, verse 44.
Matayo chapitre ya tano verse ya 49.
So I want you now to understand.
Napenda uelewe.
So I jump, Jesus said,
Yesu anasema,
pray for those who persecute you.
Ombea wale ambao wanaokutesa.
Yes. Pray for those who persecute you.
Ombea wale ambao wanakutesa.
My brother and my sister.
Ndugu yangu.
You cried a lot.
Ulishalia muda mrefu.
You cried a lot.
Ulishalia muda mrefu.
Because of persecution.
Kwa sababu ya chuki.
Mateso.
Kwa sababu ya mateso.
Because of persecution.
Kwa sababu ya mateso.
People persecute you without reason.
Watu wanakutesa bila sababu.
They do their best to make you suffer a lot.
Watu wanakuwa wanajitahidi wakufanye tu wewe
uzuri. But you do not know why.
Lakini wao hujui ni nini.
People reject you without reason.
Watu wanakuwa wanakukataa bila sababu.
Sometimes,
wakati mwingine,
you go in your bedroom.
Unaenda hata mchumbani.
You lock the door.
Unafunga hata mlango wako.
And you cry.
Na unalia.
You say, God, what did I do?
Unasema Mungu nilifanya nini?
How come I suffer like this?
Nijue nini niko nasumbuka?
My suffering today, it's because of that person.
Kama nasumbuka hivi ni kwa ajili ya mtu fulani.
Lord, am I cursed? Yes or no?
Mungu je, mie niko laana ama pana?
Oh Father.
Baba.
What's wrong with me?
Ni nini tatizo yangu?
As I told you last time.
Kama gisi nilikwambia
mwanzo. You try, you want to see another person.
Unajitahidi unaona mtu
mwingine. Who can help you?
Hamwanya anaweza kusaidia.
Nothing.
Hakuna kitu.
Instead of the Lord to help you.
Bali ya kukusaidia.
He insults you. He rejects you. He said, I am not your God. My brother and my sister, there is people in this earth, they suffer a lot. There is people who cry a lot. And they do not have a help. They say, it's better for me to die. That's why you can see many people suicide themselves. Today. Listen, my brother and my sister. This word may belong to you. God knows your situation. God knows your problem. God knows how many times you cry. And you do not get a good help. But the Lord. He's calling you today. He says, you cry a lot. And there is no help. You cry a lot.
Sir,
and nothing changes in your life. But God says, stop to cry. Now, stop to cry. But pray. Stop to cry. But pray. Stop to cry. But pray. You are so busy, that's why you do not see the face of God. God is looking for you in his presence to knee and cry, Lord. Listen, my brother. You cry a lot for people. You go to people and you cry in front of them. They do not do anything. But now, I say now,
Leo,
now,
Leo.
It is the time to cry to the Lord. To cry to the Lord. To cry to the Lord. Cry to the Lord. We want to hear your voice. The problem is you accuse a lot of people. You accuse a lot of people. I suffer because of this man. I suffer because of this woman. I suffer because of my child. Stop it. Go to your knees. God is waiting for you in your knees. God is waiting for you in His presence. God is waiting for you in His presence. We may stand up.
Aje tusimame.
Hallelujah. My brother and my sister. Stop to accuse people.
Wacha kulaumu watu.
And if you accuse people,
na kama unalaumu watu,
you will have many enemies.
Utakuwa na maadui mengi.
Who is your enemy? Who is your enemy? Maybe it's your neighbor. Maybe there is one of your friends. When you see him, you are angry because for what he did in the past. Who steal your peace?
Who stole it?
God wants you to restore friendship. God wants you to restore. Remember, God wants to bless you. God wants to bless you. But there is no way for God to bless you if there is a barrier in front of you. You need to break that barrier from enemies. God do not want to see any enemy in front of you. No man who was created by the image of God can be your enemy. As I told you before, your enemy is the devil. And when one of your friends does something wrong, do not see him, but see the one who is behind him. We are going to pray. I told you before, God answers all the time people who are hungry of Him. God answers all the time people who pray in all their hearts. People who open their hearts and say, Lord, look inside of me. God answers all the time people who recognize that they suffer a lot. Because there is people who suffer and they do not recognize it. But today, this word belongs to you. Do not go back home with that problem inside of you. The solution is now. The solution is now. Your answer is now. Just open your heart. Just open your heart. The Bible says, if you believe, then you will see the glory of God. I know you want to see the glory of God. I know you want to see the glory of God. I know you want to see God to be manifested in your heart. Just believe when you pray. Believe the presence of God in this room. No matter what you can think, believe the presence of God. God wants to visit you today. God wants to visit you today. Oh Jesus, visit your people. Visit your people. My brother and my sister, the first time you are going to pray for yourself. You are going to pray for yourself. Believe the presence of God in His room right now.
hapa.
Jesus. Jesus. Just pray where you are. Pray where you are. Pray where you are. Wherever you are, pray. I can't feel the presence of God. Just pray. Just pray, just pray. Don't hide anything. Just open your heart. Speak to your Lord all secrets. Speak to the Lord. Speak to Him. Speak to Him. Speak to Him. Father, we bless you. Father, we bless you. Father, we bless you. You know the problem. You know the request. You know our need. But today, today, the Lord is moving. The Lord is moving. He wants you to pray. He wants you to call Him. Father, visit your people. Father, visit your people. Father, visit everyone who is in this room. I believe that your hand is not short because of your mercy. I want you to visit us. I want you to touch one by one, Lord. I want you to touch. I want you to touch. Lord, touch. Lord, touch. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, 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 yes. Use your faith. Use your faith. God wants to give you the answer. Use your faith. To me, I'm an Yako. Wherever you are, to me, I'm an Yako. Whatever you are, to me, I'm an Yako. Thank you, Jesus. Omba mahali ulipo. Omba mahali ulipo. Bwana yupo. Anajua hitaji ya moyo wako. Anajua hitaji ya moyo wako. He knows the need of your heart. He knows it. But He wants you to pray. He wants you to pray. Don't say, just say, Lord, I want my answer right now. I want my answer right now, not tomorrow, right now. Sema Bwana, napenda jibu yangu sasa hivi. Everything will depend to your faith. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The glory of God is moving in this place. The glory of God is moving in this place. Utukufu wa Bwana umezunguka mahali hapa. Pray all your heart. Omba kwa moyo wako wote. Na upokee. Na upokee. Na upokee. Receive. Receive according to your faith. Receive. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Nasema machozi yako ndio mwisho. Your tear is over today. It's over. It's finished. It's finished. It's finished. Asante Baba. Baba, Father, in the name of Jesus. We come again in your presence. I surrender the life of everyone in your presence. You are the only one who knows the heart of men. And you know the heart of this woman. You know the heart of this man. And you know the heart of this child. You are our creator. And that's why we come to you today. We run to you to receive our peace, our blessings. Father, according to your word, you say without me, you cannot get anything. Father, you are our God. Wipe out our tears. We want you to change our life. Lord, right now, change the life of this woman. Right now, Lord, change the life of this man. Right now, Lord, she wants to get the answer. He wants to get the answer. He wants you to transform him. Lord, transform your people. Father, you give her the power. You say wherever you, whatever you will lock, and I will lock it in heaven. People of God, receive the peace of God. Receive the blessings of God. Receive according to your faith. Receive according to your faith. Receive your answer. Receive your answer. Receive your answer. Use your faith. God is giving you the answer. God is giving you the answer. Right now. Right now. Right now. Receive it. Right now. Receive it. In Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord protect you. May the Lord give you joy. May the Lord give whatever you want. Father, thank you for today. Now we are about to go back home. I pray for everyone who came in your presence. And I want you to be with them. Bless our houses. Bless our way. Bless this coming week. Bless tomorrow. Bless Monday. Bless Tuesday. Bless Wednesday. Bless Thursday. Bless Saturday. Bless Friday. Bless Sunday. Bless this month. Bless the next month. Bless this year. Bless the coming year. In the glory of Jesus, receive the blessing of the Lord. In Jesus Christ. Thank you very much. May the Lord bless you.